There is a quiet crisis in science education today, a crisis not of intelligence, but of vision. Too often, students are taught what to think, not how to question. The result is a generation of scientists trained to navigate within rigid paradigms, not to challenge them. Sir Fred Hoyle, former Royal Astronomer and one of the 20th century's most visionary thinkers, saw it coming. Quote, "When I qualified, the best way to get ahead was to thumb your nose at the old ones, but now you have to do what you are told. In the graduate school system, you have to learn what the professors are teaching you. A few places like Harvard set the fashion for every place. The road ahead is hammered out." Close quote. Michael Armstrong of the Thunderbolts Project captured the outcome in one sentence. Quote, "There are none so blind as those who have learned not to see." Close quote. It's not ignorance that blinds us. It's education stripped of curiosity. It's training that rewards regurgitation over imagination. Science needs to recover its rebel heart, its willingness to challenge, to explore, and to break with conventional wisdom. The bumpy road ahead. Any serious discussion of plasmas and electromagnetism in space must first confront a stubborn obstacle, the gravitational dogma of standard cosmology. While it's widely acknowledged that space is over 99% plasma, a state of matter governed by electromagnetic forces, the next logical step remains taboo. Gravity continues to hold the cosmic spotlight. Yes, magnetic fields occasionally appear in the equations, but they are often treated as secondary, and electricity all but ignored. This blind spot was the focus of the last episode in our Misconception series, and it bears repeating. To underscore the point, consider the words of Hannes Alfvén, Nobel laureate, founder of plasma physics and pioneer of plasma cosmology. This quote should be etched into the foundation of any serious study of space. I make no apology for repeating it ad nauseam. Quote, "In order to understand the phenomena in a certain plasma region, it is necessary to map not only the magnetic but also the electric field and the electric currents. Space is filled with a network of currents which transfer energy and momentum over large or very large distances." Close quote. Alfvén's insight is simple but seismic. If you ignore electricity in space, you're missing the big picture. Rethinking the universe in terms of plasma and electromagnetism demands that we abandon long-held assumptions. But if we want science to reflect reality rather than preserve legacy theories, it's a road we must take. Those who are ignorant of history. To understand the resistance to electromagnetic models, we need to look at how we got here. Gravitational models, the backbone of modern cosmology, were developed when oil lamps lit our homes and steam powered our progress. These ideas were revolutionary for their time, but over a century later, they have solidified into dogma. Yes, they brought us far, but today they struggle to explain what the universe is showing us. Instead of adapting models, cosmologists add speculative layers, dark matter, dark energy, inflation, multiverses, and so on. All grand ideas, but none of them have been directly detected. Quote, "Dark matter and dark energy are the blank checks required to postpone the falsification of bankrupt theories." Close quote, the Thunderbolts Project. Enter the James Webb Space Telescope. What it's seeing doesn't just stretch the standard model, it tears it apart. From phys.org, May 2025, quote, "It has also been revealed that galaxies in the early universe are far bigger than scientists expected, leading some to suspect there might be something wrong with our understanding of the cosmos." Close quote. The message is clear. Clinging to outdated paradigms isn't science, it's orthodoxy. And when theory refuses to bend to observation, history shows that a revolution is never far behind. Bad astronomy versus good science. Modern cosmology leans heavily on mathematical abstractions, a vision of the universe as a cold mechanical system governed solely by gravity. It offers the comfort of predictability, but ignores the dynamic forces of plasma and electromagnetism. Consider this snippet regarding an active galactic nucleus, AGN, also from viz.org. Quote, "We expect that luminosity changes this big should vary on timescales of many thousands to millions of years. But in this object, we saw it change by 10,000 over a year, and it even changed by a factor of 100 in 8 hours, which is just totally unheard of and really mind-boggling." Close quote. Erin Kira, MIT physicist. This rapid variability is shoehorned into the black hole model. Incredibly, although the model started as a placeholder, black holes are now treated as fact. The rarefaction has become reality. In this respect, plasma cosmology enjoys an advantage. The compact energetic activity at the center of galaxies is consistent with the plasma focus or plasmoid, structures replicated in the lab and known to scale across many orders of magnitude. Despite mounting evidence, many astrophysicists still treat electromagnetism as a footnote. Phil Plait inadvertently admitted as much. Quote, "Magnetism is a very important topic in astrophysics, despite some pseudoscientists lying and saying this force is ignored, but it's not well understood. In three dimensions, magnetism is ferociously difficult to model. It's a joke in astronomy. If you want to derail a talk, ask the speaker about the effects of magnetism." Close quote. That's Plait from a Bad Astronomy blog, 2008. This polemic was no doubt aimed at the electric universe. At the time, the quickest way to get banned from his bulletin board was to open a thread about plasmas. He has effectively admitted to not one but two things, a fear of electromagnetism and a refusal to engage with the electrodynamics that underlie magnetism. That's not good science. That's bad astronomy. Shift happens. To be fair to Plait, he's not alone in flinching at the mention of magnetism in space, let alone its partner in crime, electricity. Quote, "The mention of cosmic-scale magnetic fields is still likely to be met with an uncomfortable silence in some astronomical circles, and, after a bit of foot-shuffling and throat-clearing, the discussion would be moved on to safer topics. But look, they're out there. They probably do play a role in galaxy evolution, if not galaxy formation, and they certainly are a feature of the interstellar and intergalactic medium." Close quote. This quote from Universe Today in 2011 represents progress at least, albeit slow progress. Back in 1995, NASA's position was far more dismissive. Quote, "On the cosmological scale, there is no data to suggest that magnetic fields are present. They certainly are not important in the dynamics of the universe for any reasonable range of field strengths consistent with present observational constraints." Close quote. This resistance echoes what Thomas Kuhn described in his famous work, The Structure of Scientific Revolutions. Kuhn showed that science rarely evolves through a smooth accumulation of data, but through disruptive shifts in thinking, paradigm shifts. As regular viewers of this channel know, we are already witnessing the early stages of such a shift. The old guard clings to gravitational models and hypothetical constructs. Meanwhile, the plasma universe gains traction with grounded theory and testable observations. The Thunderbolts Project stands at the forefront of this movement. We are opening eyes. Fluid dynamics and the limits of analogy. In school, we're often told to imagine electricity like water in a pipe. It's a stepping stone, but ultimately misleading. Electrical energy doesn't move through a wire like water. It propagates around the wire in electromagnetic fields. Electrons inside the wire drift slowly, inches per minute, yet light bulbs switch on instantly. That's field propagation, not electron flow. A better analogy might be a train on a track. The wire guides the path, but the energy isn't carried by the material. In astrophysics, outdated analogies persist. Ion storms, electron rains, and the solar wind. All poetic phrases borrowed from fluid dynamics. The trouble is, they mask the truth. These are electromagnetic events involving charged particles in complex field interactions. If we want real progress, we need to drop the euphemisms and see plasma filaments throughout the universe for what they are. Not exotic clouds of gas or mysterious dark stuff, but as vast electrical circuits, alive with charge, energy and complexity. The myth of frozen-in magnetic fields. It would be unfair to say that mainstream astrophysics ignores the work of Hannes Alfvén entirely. The problem is more insidious. When his work is acknowledged, it is often misunderstood or misapplied. Although the concept of frozen-in magnetic fields is widely cited, for example, Alfvén later rejected this idea as a simplification that doesn't apply to real plasmas, and spent much of his later career warning against its careless use. Quote, "I had to spend a large part of my later life trying to correct this error," close quote. That's Alfvén quoted in The Big Bang Never Happened by Eric Lerner, published 1991. In ideal MHD, the frozen-in condition suggests magnetic field lines move with plasma, like sticks frozen in ice. Alfvén repeatedly emphasized that real plasmas are not ideal fluids. They involve electric currents, resistivity and complex structures such as double layers, none of which fit the frozen-in model. Quote, "The concept of frozen-in magnetic field lines belongs to ideal MHD, which does not correspond to reality." Close quote. That's Alfvén from Double Layers and Circuits in Astrophysics, published in the IEEE Transactions on Plasma Science, 1986. Magnetic fields arise from electric currents, yet astrophysics often focuses on magnetic ropes instead of addressing the underlying electrodynamic processes. This avoids uncomfortable questions about energy transport on cosmic scales. Quote, "Electric currents in space are at the heart of plasma physics, but they have been consistently neglected in cosmology," close quote. That's Alfvén from Double Layers and Circuits in Astrophysics again, as published by the IEEE. To honour his brilliant legacy, we must go beyond early citations and engage with the full scope of his insights. Media mavericks and scientific orthodoxy. In an age where media figures question everything from health policy to politics, cosmology seems curiously exempt. Joe Rogan and Russell Brand, for example, regularly challenge institutional narratives and often land themselves in hot water for doing so. Yet, when astrophysicists like Neil deGrasse Tyson or Brian Cox appear on their respective shows, the skepticism vanishes. Instead of scrutiny, we get reverence. Why does cosmology get a free pass? Speculative constructs like dark matter, dark energy, and black holes are discussed as if they were fact. The deeper issue is cultural, the myth of scientific infallibility, cloaked in jargon and delivered with confidence. An old expression springs to mind, bullshit baffles brains. Learning not to see. Astrophysical textbooks continue to downplay plasma and electromagnetism, despite plasma being the dominant state of matter in the universe. The following two examples are considered leading reference materials. Principles of Physical Cosmology by PJE, Jim Peebles, devotes over a quarter of its pages to general relativity, but mentions plasma cosmology only briefly and dismissively. Introduction to Stellar Astrophysics by Erica Bohm-Vitens gives one section out of 19 to stellar magnetism, totaling just 5 pages. Electric currents? Not even mentioned. The result? Generations of astronomers undertrained in the very forces that shape cosmic structures. Anthony Perrott is a leading plasma physicist who studied under Nobel laureate Hannes Alfvén. Quote, Astrophysicists have neglected electromagnetism in space because it is not part of their training. They tend to see the universe through the lens of gravity and nuclear fusion, and ignore anything that doesn't fit that picture. Close quote. That's Parrott from Physics of the Plasma Universe. Do you ever wonder why so many discoveries are described as bizarre, weird, or unexpected? Let's just say it's time for more cosmologists to open their eyes. Let's just say we're in the middle of a long overdue paradigm shift. Let's just say what it is, a revolution of understanding that we all live in an electric universe. And don't you know, it's going to be all right. In the next episode of this Misconception series, part 9, we will look at another common question. What about Einstein?